Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Former President Barack H. Obama visited Kenya last week. This was his first trip back to the country since leaving the Oval Office. During President Obama's years as the U.S. president, there were many accusations made against him claiming he wasn't born in the United States. Barack Obama claims he was born in Hawaii to a white female, and then raised by his white grandparents until he moved off for college in Chicago where he met Michelle Obama in the South Side. The accusations during Obama's term wasn't anything new to him. Previously, Barack Obama was accused of having a different religion back in 2004 when he was running for the U.S. Senate in Illinois. The accusations by frequent candidate for office, Andy Martin, spread to conservative publications, and many started questioning him on his values, cultural, and national loyalty, and by 2008, his citizenship. In 2008, National Review Online, and National Review contributor Jim Geraghty suggested Barack Obama release his birth certificate so the American people will know if he is or isn't an American citizen. This sparked controversy, and accusations of racism starting against anyone who spoke out against the president and questioned his citizenship. During the same year, a Democratic State Committee member from Pennsylvania brought an unsuccessful lawsuit against Barack Obama that alleged Obama was born in Mombasa, Kenya. NPR shot themselves in the foot in 2008, when an article was published that referred to Barack Obama as the Kenyan-born Senator Barack Obama. On October 24, 2012, Donald J. Trump offered a $5 million donation to a charity of his choice if the president would release his college records, applications, his passport applications, and records. Trending, Fox already replaced Kimberly after she abruptly quit for big new role, look who took her place. All that being said, Obama had a slip of the tongue during a speech in Kajello, Kenya last week. Now, 3 years ago, I visited Kenya as the first sitting American president to come from Kenya, he said. There was a pause and then loud cheers and applause from the crowd after he made his remark at the 5:49 mark of the 15-minute speech. Watch. Recalling a visit to the country when he was president, Obama said, 3 years ago, I visited Kenya as the first sitting American president to come from Kenya. Obama didn't skip a beat, and he didn't take back the comment. He didn't say he made a mistake, and he didn't joke about what he said. He seemed to be on the up and up about it. Was he speaking the truth? From the heart. Let's go back to last year. In 2017, Obama's half-brother, Malik Obama, tweeted an image of what appears to be Barack's birth certificate. Except it's not from Hawaii, but rather Kenya. What's this? He tweeted. The document is from the Coast Province General Hospital, in Mombasa, British Protectorate of Kenya, and is for Barack Hussein Obama II, who was born on the 4th day of August 1961. In 2011, the White House released what it claimed was President Obama's long-form birth certificate. The president believed the distraction over his birth certificate wasn't good for the country. It may have been good politics and good TV, but it was bad for the American people and distracting from the many challenges we face as a country. Therefore, the president directed his counsel to review the legal authority for seeking access to the long-form certificate and to request on that basis that the Hawaii State Department of Health make an exception to release a copy of his long-form birth certificate. American Mirror Obama's staff released this image of his Hawaii birth certificate, who knows if it was real or not. The question everyone should be asking right now, why did Barack Obama admit he's from Kenya, and the media has yet to say anything about it? That's right, the media knew the truth the entire time but wanted to make sure Barack Obama stayed president of the United States so they could keep pushing the leftist agenda. Anyone who thinks Barack Obama's presidency wasn't planned years in advance is sadly mistaken. The Daily Mail reported that Barack Obama was still Kenyan-born in 2007 according to his literary agency 2 months after announcing his bid for the U.S. presidency. Barack Obama's literary agents were still listing the U.S. president's birthplace as Kenya in their online author bios 2 months after he first announced his run for president in 2007. Viewed on web.archive.org, the April 3, 2007 listing from Acton and Distel for Mr. Obama still touts the then Democratic junior senator from Illinois as born in Kenya. Indeed, the short biography even references his now famous speech to the Democratic National Convention, which launched Mr. Obama to national fame and announced him as a potential candidate for the presidency. However, the next available listing online at web.archive.org is from April 21, 2007, and the future president's biography has changed to state that Barack Obama was born in Hawaii and not Kenya. By the time the biography was changed, Mr. Obama had been sitting in the U.S. Senate for 2 years. This new information comes as the row over Mr. Obama's heritage was reignited by the discovery of a 1991 booklet boldly announcing that the Democrat was born in Kenya and raised in Indonesia and Hawaii. The truth will always come out. Note from the editor, the views and opinions expressed in this article are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the position of this website or of the owners, administrators of where this article is shared online. Claims are made in this piece are based on the author's own opinion and not stated as evidence of fact.